What's up, everybody? It's Mateo from Alchemist Ventures, where we help artists grow, brand, and market worldwide. First and foremost, thank you to everybody who has supported the channel. The last month, we've just crossed 1,500 subscribers, about 400 new subscribers in the last 30 days. So it's been a great amount of support. So thank you to everybody. And today we have a very special video on how to create and use an electronic press kit, an EPK. And we also have the first guest on our channel, David Nazario. He's a music journalist, an author, and a speaker. He also just released his first book, Make Love Your Religion. We'll have the link to the book in the description as you go check it out. We'll cover more about it at the end of the video, but he's gonna break down essentially why it's important to have an EPK, how to make an EPK. So David, introduce yourself.
Cool, so my name is David Nazario, as Mateo said. As he said, I'm a writer, speaker, author, music journalist. I got my start in the music business as a writer about 7 years ago. I was a senior editor of a magazine called Mute Magazine, internationally recognized print and online publication. And we covered a lot of different artists, everyone from Meek Mill before he blew up, to Styles P, to Cormega, to Joel Ortiz. I did some work for Mixology.com, which is a music website based in San Francisco, doing a lot of big things. And I currently write for Sway.com, excuse me. And I enjoy writing a lot of articles that have to do with hip hop culture. Because of that, I've been able to learn a little bit about, well, a lot about what goes on behind the scenes as far as artists reaching out to media and different publications.
And that's a question that, you know, artists have all the time is, how do I get on this blog? Right. How do I get on this magazine? How do I get to this music journalist, my music, for them to cover me? So right. In this video, you're gonna realize how important it is to have a professional EPK. Not having that piece of resume will separate you from all the other artists who don't have one. For as far sure. as professionalism, because that goes a long way. Break down, what is an electronic press kit?
Right, so an electronic press kit, the acronym EPK, so if you hear that word, it's important for you to know the jargon as somebody that's in the music industry, as an artist on the come up, or somebody that's established. So an EPK is an electronic press kit, and basically what it is it's a professional resume for you and your music. It's the time to brag, right? You want to use this press kit as something that is showing the public or whoever comes across it. So showing them who you are as an artist, what it is that you've done, what it is that you plan to do, and of course you want to make your music shine as well. So we'll go step by step on some of the things that you need to know when it's time for you to put together your electronic press kit. One of the first things you want to make sure of is that everything in your electronic press kit is on brand. You want to tell a story, you want to make it as personal as possible, so the person that sees it, they have an idea of who you are as an artist. And in regards to who's going to see your electronic press kit and why it's so important, so there's a couple groups of people that are going to see your electronic press kit. Promoters, for one. Other artists might see your electronic press kit. Radio stations, music festivals, those people who are deciding who they're going to allow to perform at their music festival. Managers, record labels. So all of these important people within the industry are going to see your electronic press kit. So that's why it's important to make sure that you have one and make sure that it's on point.
And some won't even reply to your email if you don't even have an EPK sent to them.
For sure. So what should be included in your electronic press kit? Obviously, the number one thing is your music, right? This is the first chance that promoters, that journalists are going to have a chance to get an idea of who you are as a musician and what type of music that you make. So you need to have two forms of music on your electronic press kit, and you need to make sure that it's digital as well, and that you have the links to these things in your press kit so people can watch your videos on your press kit, and they can also hear audio. A lot of times people will go to the audio first, so you want to make sure that you pick out three songs, three of your best songs, three of the your dopest tracks that you have, and put those on your electronic press kit. Look at what songs of yours have the most downloads, or what songs have been bought the most. So just try to gauge which songs are your best songs, which ones are going to connect with listeners most, and you want to put those up there first. Next up, you want to make sure that you have high quality, high res photos on your electronic press kit. As we all know, with the world of Instagram and social media, everything is visual. So you want to make sure that it's aesthetically pleasing. So make sure that you connect with a friend of yours or a professional photographer, or maybe you just want to get a good quality camera and learn how to work it yourself, and you know, get out there with a friend or somebody who's well versed with photography to get you some high quality photos.
It makes sense to just use the photos you might already have on your Spotify profile, your Apple Music profile. Those cover photos could just be used on your EPK. So if you already did a photo shoot for all the branding on your streaming platforms, just grab it and put it on EPK, because those are the most professional invisible photos you have.
You also want to make sure that you have a professional bio on your press kit. So it's not a good idea for you to write your bio yourself. It's a great idea for you to reach out to a professional writer, have them write the bio for you. You have to also keep in mind that journalists, when they're writing about you and who you are as an artist and your artistry, they're going to look on that. They're going to look to the electronic press kit to figure out how they're going to put their story together. So you can be in charge of shaping how that journalist tells your story based on the way that you put your electronic press kit together. And definitely your bio is a big part of that.
And if you don't have a bio, this is a great time to reach out to David or anybody who writes bios, simply because a bio, like you said, is very important. It's going to be featured on EPK. And if it's featured on EPK, you can use that same bio to put it on your Spotify profile,
right,
your about section on YouTube, your Facebook sections.
The other thing that you want to add on to your electronic press kit is any events that you have coming up, any events that you have done, any tour dates that you have coming up as well. You want to let the media know, let the journalists know, let the publicists know, the record companies know that you are active, that you've been active, and you have things that you're currently doing as well as things that are coming up in the future. Another thing that you need to add to your electronic press kit is any type of press that you've gotten. So if your song was featured on a hip-hop website, on an indie rock website, whatever type of website, music related website, you want to make sure that you add that onto your electronic press kit so that the media, so that the journalists, the people that are looking at it, the promoters, they know that this is not your, you're not new to this, you have some experience, and you are someone that the media feels is important to cover in some aspects. So anytime that you've been on any type of blogs or podcasts, newspaper articles, all of those things.
Playlists, you know, nowadays as well.
Playlists,
you can easily, yep, add those into the EPK.
All of your social media links should be on your electronic press kit. You should make it very easy to continue telling your story, because your electronic press kit is telling your story to a degree, but then you want to have a link to your Instagram and your Facebook page and your Twitter and all of those different things, so that way you can continue telling your story how you want it to be told. So when those journalists, those publicists and people like that go to your electronic press kit and then follow your links to your socials, they get a better idea of who you are. You also want to make sure that you have your website link on your electronic press kit. You want to make it very easy for the people that are looking at it to know where to find you, to know where to hear more of your music, to know where to see more of your videos and things like that. So make sure that you have your website on there. Make sure that you have all your social channels on there. And also make sure you list where they can purchase your music at. Make sure that that's on your electronic press kit as well. And last but not least, you want to make sure that it's very easy for them to contact you. So you want to make sure that you give a phone number to your manager, or an email to your manager, an email to your company, your website, what have you. So that way they know how to get in contact with you and they don't have to fish around for those things. They can contact you very easily. Last but not least, there's a couple different resources that you can use if you are looking to put together your electronic press kit. Adobe Spark has a great program. They have a lot of different templates that you can use. There's three different options. There's a free option, there's a $9.99 option, and there's a $19.99 option. It's kind of set up like a website, and you can kind of think of your electronic press kit as a website in a sense. I think it's also a good idea for you to have a separate official website, but Adobe Spark makes an electronic press kit that's similar to what you might find on a website, but that's a good source for you. You can also look into SonicBiz. They do a great job of providing templates for you to use. A lot of good information on there about how to put your electronic press kit together as well. Last but not least, you can use Adobe Illustrator if you like to, if you're well versed with Adobe Illustrator. It's a good way for you to put your electronic press kit together.
All right, everybody, so I hope you enjoyed the video on how to create an EPK, why it's so important to have an EPK, which again stands for electronic press kit. They're very essential to not only furthering your career, but to just be seen or perceived as a professional artist. It just separates you from all the tons and tons of artists who are just DMing and spamming links and commenting on people's posts. Again, David, if you reach out to him, he's gonna do a 10% off for an EPK. He'll write one for you, or for bios as well. Again, bios are very important for your Spotify profile, your YouTube about section, for Facebook. You need a bio almost everywhere you can possibly look, especially your website. So reach out to David. Again, his email will be in the description. And here's a great example of a finished EPK. Now, you can't click on this video, but this EPK, you can actually click on his social links. You can click to the individual mixtapes that he's put out on his career. So it's a very easy way for a music journalist, let's say for David, if he were to receive this EPK, he'd be able to click on the music, listen to it. Because if he had to go search for the music, that's already a headache in itself, because he's getting tons of emails. So again, this is what separates a great EPK from an average one. And if you send your EPK to a journalist who only covers rock, they might not even write the blog post, but if they have a great EPK, they might be willing to recommend or send you to another music journalist that they know on hip hop or whatever genre you're creating music. So David, thank you for breaking down to the people how to make an EPK, why it's so important. So let's talk a little bit about the book, how it relates to artists, and you know, plug yourself in, where they can find you and email you.
So definitely my first book, Make Love Your Religion, How to Put Love First and Succeed at Doing What You Love. It's for artists, it's for entrepreneurs, it's for dreamers, it's for doers, it's for anyone that there's a spiritual element to the book, but it's also for entrepreneurs and for people that are looking to live out their dreams. And I know all of you guys out there that are artists are looking to do that. You're not doing this, it's fun, but you're doing this because it's a greater purpose and this is something that you really love to do. So my book is all about putting love first in every aspect of our life, in terms of how we take care of ourselves, in terms of how we treat our community, in terms of how we pursue our dreams, the way we live our lives, the goals that we set for ourselves, and putting love first, and also figuring out how it is that you can do what you love to do and make a living doing it. I've never had a full-time job in my life. I'm 34 years old. I've only done what I love to do, which is write, speak, and work with young people. You can definitely check it out. It's on Google Play right now. It's also on Amazon. And
you could reach out to you directly.
Reach out to me directly. My Instagram is scared of Instagram and Twitter, scared of a day job. Just how it sounds, scared of a day job without the O in job.
So, everything will be linked in the description. His Instagram, his Twitter, and his email. So again, you would write some bios and EPKs.
For sure, I would be happy to. I love to interview artists and learn about their stories and then put that into a bio. It's one of my favorite things to do. It's one of the things that I love to do. So I'd be happy to do that for you guys. Feel free to reach out. My email is david@scaredofadayjob.com.
All right, everybody. So again, thank you for watching. Thank you for the constant support. Make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below on what you learned today as far as EPKs, how to create one. If you have any questions, again, leave them in the comment section. David's book and his social profiles will be linked in the description. So go comment. A book or reach out to him if you need some bios or some EPKs done. Make sure to hit that like button, hit that thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and thank you for watching once again. Peace.